عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome guys. Today I want to share with you guys a very interesting development that I noticed between the modern scholars of Christianity and the church fathers. Okay, I'm going to explain to you a very interesting thing about the doctrine of the Trinity. Okay, so you had modern scholars, someone like Dr. William Lane Craig and Dr. Ryan Mullins, okay? These individuals, they have denied a particular doctrine of the church fathers, which the church fathers strongly held on to. They have denied it for the reasons I'm going to present for you guys. Okay, so because of the way we think today, things have changed from at that time. So they saw it necessary or deem it fit to change some of these ideas, okay? So that's let me just present to you the whole idea. So modern scholars versus the church fathers about the Trinity, okay? Now, in that time, around the time of the Council of Nicaea and after that, the church fathers emphasized on a particular doctrine that most people might not be aware of. They emphasized on the notion that, see, if you have the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Father must, listen to this, the Father must be the one that caused the Son. Must. And the Father must be the one that caused the Holy Spirit, or the Son caused the Holy Spirit. But the Father is the only one there that has no causal relation or causal dependence on anybody. The Son and the Holy Spirit necessarily must be depend on the Father. Why? They use this idea that says, see, There's only one unoriginate. Okay, so the Father originated the Son and the Holy Spirit. Only the Father is unoriginate. Okay, so they gave the Father this thing that, see, only the Father is unoriginate. And they thought, this is how, if you deny this, so they made it a case that if you say that the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, they are all unoriginate, in the case where it will look like something like this, where you will have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and there's no causal link between them, they just exist like this, three uncaused persons, the church fathers say this is tritheism. Do you hear? The church fathers, they said, it's tritheism. That if you have three unoriginate, you have tritheism. Imagine you have three unoriginate. You have tritheism. This is what the church fathers are saying. So they want to maintain that the Father is the one that caused the Son and the Holy Spirit. So let me even show you some of the things that they said. If you've ever heard that verse in the Bible where it says, the Father is greater than I. You know that verse where he says, the Father is greater than I? The church fathers, they will say, someone like Athanasius. Athanasius, if you don't know Athanasius, bro, this guy was like the guy of the Nicaea. If you don't know this guy, you don't know anybody. So Athanasius, he was part of those fathers that were saying, the Father is greater than I, means that the Father is greater for only one reason, okay? Because they want to, remember, they all maintain the homoousios stuff. So they said the Father is greater because he's unoriginate, whereas the Son is originate. That is the only reason why the Father is greater. So let me now show you what now happened. The modern scholars, someone like William Lane Craig, okay? William Lane Craig and someone like Dr. Ryan Mullins, okay? If you don't know, Dr. Ryan Mullins is popular for this against divine simplicity arguments. Everyone should know Dr. William Lane Craig, okay? Everyone should know him. So anyway, they are taking on this view. You see, this is the first view, one unoriginate. And they said, if you have three unoriginate, you have tritheism. The church fathers are saying this, not me, the church fathers. Now, William Lane Craig, Dr. William Lane Craig, and Ryan Mullins, they are saying, this is the view you have to take. Three unoriginate, that is the view you have to take. For why? Why are they saying this? I'm going to tell you why they are taking this position and neglecting this position. Remember what I just showed you now. I don't think you guys noticed it. The church fathers are admitting that, for some reason, okay, that the Father is greater than the Son. They have admitted this. You see, this is what William Lane Craig and Ryan Mullins, these guys are trying to avoid. That how can you even say this? That the Father is greater than the Son, and yet you want to say that they are co-equal? It doesn't make any sense. So them, they are saying why? Because there's this property now that everyone is emphasizing on. It's a property of being aseity. I must have said it many times on this stream, actually. Okay? If you've been listening. Aseity. Okay? The property of being uncaused. You're independent. You don't depend on someone else for your own existence. Now, everyone understands this doctrine of aseity stuff. So now, if you now say the Son is not asei, and aseity is supposed to be a divine property, if you say the Son doesn't have that because of this, because the Son is caused, you have made that connection, the Son is caused, and the Holy Spirit is caused, therefore, both of them, using perfect being theology, they will not have that property of that divine property, and therefore, they cannot be God. Do you see? So, when you say they are co-equal, the Ryan Mullins and William Lane Craig, they are saying there's still something that is still left to make them really co-equal. Such that, you see, the church fathers, no one forced them. They said this. They said the Father is greater than the Son. But they didn't mean it in a very strong sense, okay? They said this anyway. Whereas, Ryan Mullins and William Lane Craig, them, they want to say, see. Because, let me just write it here. The consequence that follow from this idea of causation, that the Father eternally, by the way, they say it's eternal. It's not like the Son and the Holy Spirit pop into existence. It doesn't matter. The causal link between them, all the church fathers, they affirm this. Okay? What would happen is that the Father, okay, will be greater than the Son and the Holy Spirit. Do you see? Well, that's what will follow from this causal link. Now, William Lane Craig and Ryan Mullins, they remove this causal link and they say, you know what, we don't need to do this. We can just, the Son is eternal, it's uncaused, it doesn't depend on the Father for his existence. Three ultimate, unoriginate beings just exist. What this will do is that it will make the Father equal to the Son and equal to the Holy Spirit. So, which one can you swallow? Which one are you willing to swallow? Do you want to affirm subordination or you want to affirm co-equality? So, in a way, truly speaking, Ryan Mullins and William Lane Craig, they're actually much more, if you truly want to maintain co-equality, these guys are the guys that are actually on the right track. Because why would you say the Father is greater than the Son? And then you're saying they are co-equal? Do you see? That is why they are going this route. Of saying, you know what, we don't need this causal eternal generation stuff. It's called eternal generation, by the way. We don't need it. Because all it would do is cause subordination between the Son and the Holy Spirit. Whereas we want to maintain their co-equal. So I hope you get the distinction between them. So while the church fathers would charge them with tritheism, by the way, Ryan Mullins, he wrote an entire paper dismissing this notion that for some reason, I've said this before, why would this not be tritheistic? This is tritheistic to me. Why would you say them, because they have three unoriginate persons, they have tritheism? The church fathers are saying that. You have one unoriginate and two originate. Okay? Two originate, one unoriginate. So what? It's just three. Still three gods. Do you see? If you charge them with tritheism, you also tritheist. You just have your own, it's just subordination in your own idea of God. If they are tritheist, you are also tritheist. That's what they don't get. Because why? It doesn't matter if one God caused the other God to exist. As long as, by the way, let me just tell you, all this, Ryan Mullins, he wrote a particular paper where he showed all the things that the church fathers want to use to maintain their own monotheism. For example, love, many things. He said they can also use it too. They can use love that, okay, what if three unoriginate beings love themselves? If you think, if the church fathers taught all those things, preserved monotheism, why are they charging them with tritheism? This is where the incoherence comes in. They can also appeal to love, okay? These three beings, they love each other, and eternally, they love each other, they are eternal, they are co-equal, and everything. They can use all those things that you are using to try and maintain your monotheism. Divine simplicity, they can use it too. So what? So why would they be tritheists and you will not? Okay, so this is why these scholars, they feel confident that they can take this position against the church fathers. And in fact, they will charge the father, if the church fathers charge them with tritheism, they will charge the church fathers with subordinationism. Okay, so this is subordinationism, right? These guys are tritheists, these guys are subordinationism. To me, all of them, both Ryan Mullins, modern scholars, these guys, and the church fathers, they are all tritheists. They are all tritheists, you see? Because what they are talking about is not relevant in this discussion. What matters is how many individuals are there. If you have more than one individual in your doctrine of God, bro, let's just go, man. You're a polytheist, okay? But I think these guys, they are saying, okay, if we are going to rely on Christian history, and if the entire Christian history, they've always believed in some kind of Trinity stuff, this has to be the best form of it. To go full-blown and appeal to three originate beings, and yet they are still one God for some reason. There's still monotheism there. That's what they... So in a way, they are showing that your charge against us, it doesn't work. I hope you get the idea of this video. So I just wanted to share with you guys. At the end of the day, none of them is monotheistic in the strict sense. When we analyze it strictly, none of them is monotheistic. Unless they appeal to this kind of... where the persons, that's the next video I will make, where the persons are not really persons. They are just like aspects of the one God, where there's only one self, one individual that has different modes. That's the only way you can get monotheism out of that. If you want to use this kind of social stuff and you are using love and all those things, it's not going to work. So, hope you get this video. So, see you guys later. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.